Now, the WGAL News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Ethan Houston.
We had a beautiful weekend and also a beautiful start to the work week. Lots of sunshine today and temperatures were above average. We're going to do this all again for tomorrow, but we've got another chilly night in store because our skies are clear and our winds are going to be relatively calm. So all is quiet right now over Hershey with just a gentle breeze out of the northwest. We're at 33 right now in Chocolate Town. Feels like it's 26. We've got a clear scan on live local 8 radar. It's going to stay this way for a few more days, but through the night tonight, look for the temperatures to fall into the mid to upper 20s with just a few passing clouds at times as we get closer to dawn. That's also going to be the case first thing in the morning. Could be some frost on the ground. May have to grab the ice scraper if you're going to be out and about right around dawn, but it is going to be another beautiful day tomorrow with highs above average with very little, if any, cloud cover. Made it to 45 for our high today after a morning low of 25. The average high now is right around 40 degrees. We've cooled off to the 20s and 30s across much of the region. 34 if you're watching us in Gettysburg, and it's also 34 in Elizabethtown, Lancaster County. So cooler air to the north, milder air down to the south, and man, oh man, has Southern California been hit hard with heavy rain. It's been a deluge of that heavy rain through the weekend. That's actually our next storm system. High pressure firmly in control of our weather as it's centered over the Great Lakes and another ridge of high pressure over the Red River Valley. But zoom in and let's talk about this heavy rainfall over Southern California. Here's a look at some rainfall totals. Beverly Hills, close to 8 inches of rain during the past 3 days. Downtown Los Angeles picking up 7 inches. They typically see about 14 inches of rain an entire year. So in the past 3 days, Southern California has picked up about a half of a year's worth of rainfall. So we've got a couple of days before this storm system works its way to the east, and it is going to weaken as it approaches the valley. So enjoy the sunny streak as it will continue for the next few days. High pressure firmly in control. There you can see just a few passing clouds as we start tomorrow morning, but I do expect abundant sunshine throughout much of the day tomorrow. This will also be the case heading through the day on Wednesday, with temperatures starting to return to the 50s by the time we head closer to Thursday, but the clouds will start building in. That's the leading edge of the moisture, and then the rain chances will go up for your Friday. As of right now, the rain looks to be spotty and light in nature, and some of that may continue on into Saturday. So temperatures will rise into the 50s for Thursday, and then here comes a weak storm system that will bring us a few passing showers, most likely in the afternoon and evening hours. We'll keep the chances for those showers around on Saturday, but highs will be close to 60 degrees. We're dry for your Sunday, but then here comes a stronger storm for your Monday. This will bring showers to the region and cooler temperatures, with temperatures start to fall back down closer to seasonal averages as we head through much of next week. As of right now, it looks like Valentine's Day next week will be dry.